standard versus long-range electric vehicle, which is better? Hello, in this short video, we will specifically address the Hyundai Ioniq 5, Fisker Ocean, Tesla Model Y, and 3. While we will address these specifically, similar concepts apply to any EV that offers a standard range and a long or extended range battery pack options. First question you need to ask yourself, is the standard range mileage enough for you? Then compare the price of the upgrade versus how many additional miles you would get for the longer range EV, to see if it is worth the consideration. First, the Hyundai Ioniq 5 SE rear-wheel drive. As we covered in our top 5 value and cost EV list, we do not recommend the standard range version since the long range version is about $3,000 more, but gives you 83 extra miles of range. That is a fantastic value for the extra range from the standard of 220 to the extended, with 303 miles of EPA range. Next, the Fisker Ocean SUV. It offers 250 miles in the Ocean Sport front-wheel drive trim versus 340 miles in the Ocean Ultra all-wheel drive trim. The base price difference is about $12,500 more for the extra 90 miles and all-wheel drive, plus some extra standard features. That is a rather large dollar spread for the extra range, unless you value the all-wheel drive and extra options. However, if you expect to take a lot of long road trips, that range will be handy, if you can afford the difference. Now for the Model Y standard range all-wheel drive versus the long range, which is in our top 7 SUV EVs comparison list. The standard range all-wheel drive gives you 279 EPA miles with the 19-inch wheels, versus the long-range all-wheel drive with 330 EPA miles. Here, the difference financially is not as easy as the Hyundai, with 51 extra miles of EPA range for about the same $3,000 difference. At that difference, it will depend on how often you plan on taking a road trip with the vehicle. If you expect to often, then that extra range will be useful and might save you a charging stop that you otherwise wouldn't take. For the Model 3, the comparison is more difficult because at the time of this video, you could not order a long-range Model 3. The standard range rear-wheel drive has an EPA of 272 miles versus the last version of the long-range all-wheel drive that had an EPA of 358 miles for about $5,000 to $6,000 more. That was about 86 additional miles on the long range, but at about twice the cost of the difference on the Hyundai. Similar to the Model Y, if you expect to take a lot of long road trips, then the longer range version will ultimately save you a lot of time. However, if you are mostly commuting and driving less than 200 miles in a day, the standard range has an LFP or lithium iron phosphate battery and is rated for even higher charge cycles than the long range battery. Though both are warranted for 8 years or 100,000 miles on the standard range and 120,000 miles on the long range. This comes down to how far you drive. Now for the big question, can you and should you afford the extra cost for the extra range? If the standard range of any EV is more than enough for you, then over time, knowing that as the battery technology improves, you will likely be able to upgrade your electric vehicle to a future standard range that is like what a long range is now. Kinda like many people do with their mobile devices. What we don't know is how soon that will happen. Please like, comment, subscribe and share. Let us know in the comments if you agree or disagree with our suggestions, and thanks for watching.